we just might do this. We got Kellogg, thanks to you, and so many synths. Justice will be served.
The Great Green Jewel. Diamond City is a place where everyone knows everyone, and no one talks to anyone. She's a sight. Everyone who's anyone in the Commonwealth is from here, settled here, got kicked out of here. A big wall, some power, working plumbing, schools, and some security goons are what make Diamond City the big monster it is. Now, the big question. Why come to Diamond City? Love it or hate it. You'll see for yourself soon enough. Another great day in Diamond City.
I can't believe I'm posted outside the wall. Who the heck did I piss off? Head on inside.
Are we going to see this baseball game? How exciting!
Perhaps now would be a good time to speak?
Of course. Go right ahead.
So gracious, son. I do appreciate it. I've always had such admiration for you and your family, ever since the day my visual sensors were first switched on. You and the missus, so good with young Sean, and so trusting of me to look after such a newborn bundle of joy. It just warms my nuclear core. So, you can imagine the distress I felt when the bombs fell, after you fled to the vault. I searched, but found no evidence of your death. I could only hope you all made it in time. And when you returned, I was overjoyed. I admit I ran a full diagnostic scan just to make sure I wasn't malfunctioning. But the news of the missus and Sean, believe me when I say it takes a true hero to live through that. Cat got your son, sir?
You think I'm a hero? I'm far from it.
Don't sell yourself short, sir. In such a bleak world as this, think of all you've witnessed and all you've done. In my 200 years, I've seen it tear good men and women apart. But you, sir, you have remained the very model of what humanity should aspire to be.
I didn't realize you felt that way, Cosworth. I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything, sir. I just felt you should know what you've come to mean to me. I truly believe if the Commonwealth is to turn itself around, you're the one to do it. Now, not another word. I stand firm in my belief. Let's get back to it.
I don't know why we let Valentine live in the city. He saves one or two people, and everyone forgets he's a freaking sin.
You need a genuine, authentic, custom-made hickory swat.
Gonna pass.
Fine. Get going.
Hold position.
On it.
Come on, Nikki. I'm just asking for your opinion. It'd be a great quote.
He's my client, Piper. Why don't you learn not to snoop on a man's private affairs?
Well, well. Speak of the devil.
You're back. And not with your son. What happened?
Where do you want me to start? The part where Kellogg turned out to be working for the Institute? Or the part where he told me they have Sean?
The Institute? Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, friend. Truly. That makes things considerably more complicated.
He ain't kidding. Heck, Nick's a synth, and even he doesn't know how to get in.
No synth does. Security protocols strip those memories out.
You don't know anything, Nick?
I woke up in a junk pile ages ago. Just another discarded prototype. The Institute hasn't come calling since. I'm sorry.
I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there, but to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg. Huh.
Whatever you're thinking, it doesn't matter. He's dead.
Yeah. Figures the Institute's only man on the outside wouldn't be the type to be taken alive.
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
So, what now?
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
Who's this Dr. Amari?
I'll let her give you her life story in person. Let's stay focused. I guess we're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the Memory Den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
Anything else you can tell me about the Memory Den?
It's in Good Neighbor, a little slice of trouble northeast a ways. The Memory Den ain't just a fancy name. It's literal. A lot of people give up all their caps just to relive the good parts of their lives. Over and over. But not us. We're gonna try to dive deep into someone else's mind. I can meet you there, or we can head out together.
I'll head out with Piper. We'll meet you there, Nick.
Sounds good. You two stay out of trouble. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
Oh, that's the face I fell in love with.
Piper.
You know, the Institute has a lot of enemies. The Minutemen tangled with them once. The Railroad still does. They've even got some notes on these new guys. You know that group you rescued and conquered? As far as I know, they're the last Minutemen left in the Commonwealth. They used to be a volunteer army, dedicated to protecting friends, family, and neighbors. Sounds soft, but they were a real thing at one point.
You said something about the Railroad.
Supposedly, they help runaway synths escape the Institute, but they're secretive.
Hold for paranoid.
The only thing I have is a rumor. A code phrase. Follow the Freedom Trail.
It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself, protect your family. Now let's enjoy a little fun. Let's see if I see.
You hungry? These always keep me going. Have any more questions about the Institute's enemies, Blue? The Brotherhood of Steel doesn't do subtle. From what I've heard, they take whatever they want. Especially if it's high tech. They just might have the muscle to give the Institute a run for their money, but they're... Let's just say they have their own agenda.
Well, Mr. Valentine. I thought you had forgotten about the money.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Nick.
Let's go talk to Amari.
Wait there.
I will wait. It is safe here, yes?
Okay. I'll be here then.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
This one's all yours, Nick.
We need a memory dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you two mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
How much of the brain do you need exactly?
That is not an encouraging question. I suppose I'll have to make do with whatever you can find.
Here's what I could find.
This isn't a brain. This is... Wait. That's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, All Institute technology has a similar architecture.
So the brain is still good, right?
Possibly. There's no sign of decay, so the tech is probably preserving the tissue, injecting some kind of compound to keep it stable. But there's no way to access the memories inside without a compatible port.
You're talking about me, right? I'm an old synth. If the Institute built me out of similar parts, we might have an in.
There could be long-term side effects. I don't know where to even begin with listing the risks.
Don't bother. I don't need to hear them. Plug me in, Doc.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right, let's do this.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
How do you lock memories?
The implant is encoding all the mnemonic activity in the hippocampus. Think of it like computer encryption, and we don't have the password. Let's see. A single mind wouldn't be able to crack it, but what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Any idea what I'm gonna see in there?
I have no clue. But considering we only have a single piece of the medial temporal lobe and not the whole brain, I doubt it'll be cohesive.
Nick and I are gonna share a mind? Yeah, I'm not gonna see him in any compromising positions, am I?
Yeah, if a smart mouth was all it took to solve problems, we would have found your son by now.
No. You won't have to worry about that. The only memories you'll access are the ones in the implant.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there, and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
He must have run with one of the Raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
Sure, that's gonna take some getting used to for a lot of people.
What a joke. What's it mean, Mom? Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe. Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days. Like before the big war. Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless, but you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio, all useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. We'll let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah. You've gotta give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kinda green.
I know. But that's where I come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the She. A lot of standing around looking tough.
They sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got it. Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer. The thing about happiness is you only know you had it, and it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. You focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand. That's what happiness felt like.
I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
From that time. It all kind of blends together. It was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself. I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe. It was always a job for someone like me. Didn't matter what it was. Didn't matter who I was supposed to kill. I got pretty good at it.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you.
There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but, dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. I just took it as part of the job. A little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end. One way or another.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it? So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
Mr. Kellogg. I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed. And I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Which suited me just fine. What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate. Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
suspended.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just find him.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
This is the one. Here.
Open it. I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but, still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here.
Wait. No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you, Sean!
God damn it.
I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really. The eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me, and I made sure they knew it.
What's the holdup? I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long.
Come on, come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.